Are you looking for a secure and efficient way to manage your containers? Or maybe you've already heard of Podman as a Docker alternative and you're looking to learn more. Well, your search ends here. Today, we're going to be doing a deep dive into what Podman is as a container engine. Now, my name is Cedric Clyburn. I'm a developer advocate at Red Hat, and the IBM folks have graciously allowed me to come in today to introduce Podman and show you not only what Podman is, but how it works and how to get started. So really quickly, before we dive into what Podman is, let's quickly talk about why containers are so crucial and set up the scene for Podman. Now, let's say we're a developer and we just finished developing our application. Let's say maybe it's a Java app, or could be Node, or could be Python, whatever it may be. Now, say we want to run it on another developer's computer, or maybe run it in the cloud. How do we take this application along with its code base, its runtime, maybe it's using the JDK, and its libraries, and ensure that this is compatible on maybe another developer's machine or different environments such as QA, development, and prod? Well, this is where containerization comes in, effectively encapsulating your entire application into one single transferable unit that can run the same way anywhere you want to deploy it. So say it's our colleague's computer. We can run it over there, or we can take our same application and run it anywhere on a server in the hybrid cloud. This effectively gets rid of the, oh, it works on my machine issue that we as developers face way too often. Now, this is where Podman comes in. So Podman is a container engine. It's an open source project that helps us with developing containers. It helps us with managing both the containers and the images, and it helps us to deploy containers. So it's a super powerful tool, and it has two unique features about it that make it different from other container engines. Firstly, is its daemonless approach. Now, if we look at another popular container engine such as Docker, what we'll notice is that when we're working with the Docker CLI on our terminal or maybe using Docker Desktop, what's actually happening is we're doing functions such as building an image or running a container. And what we're actually doing is talking to something in the background called the Docker daemon. Now, what is the Docker daemon? Well, it's commonly referred to as the Docker engine, and it's responsible for all the heavy lifting. So it'll create containers for us, it'll help us build images, and it'll do a lot of other functions, but it's running in the background as a system process, and it's running as root. So we have this daemon that's responsible for all the heavy lifting. This is what's known as a client-server architecture. Now, Podman is a little bit different in its architecture. Podman uses something known as the fork exec model. So instead of having this background daemon process running in the background to create containers, work with images, now we're doing everything from the client itself. So when we're creating a container, Podman is actually forking itself, and this child process then becomes the container. So this difference in architecture makes Podman unique and makes it more efficient, lightweight, and secure when it comes to container engines. Now, this also brings us to the point of something called a single point of failure. Say, for example, that our Docker engine running in the background was to suddenly crash, become unresponsive, or be quit. Now we no longer have access to the containers, images, and anything else that's attached to the Docker engine. So this is what makes Podman unique, is its daemonless approach. But because of this architecture, this brings us into the root versus rootless idea. So say we're having an application running on our computer. So say we're running it as root. Of course, that's going to bring in several security implications. Say there's a vulnerability, like we commonly see with a lot of applications nowadays. If that was to be exploited and taken advantage of by a hacker, now the application could go rogue and our entire system is at risk. But say we had this same application and we're running it not as root, just as a regular user. Well, we have the same vulnerability. However, if a hacker were to exploit this vulnerability, the container, the application, is only running as a non-root user. So only our user could be affected. This effectively adds another level of security as a container engine and is the difference between the approaches of Docker, where the Docker engine is running in the background as root, and Podman, which with its rootless approach and daemonless approach allows you to run by default containers just as a user and not as root. Now, you'll notice some similarities when we drew the architecture of Docker and Podman. This is because they're both based on something called the OCI, which is the Open Container Initiative, which has some standards for how we work with container technologies. This means that if you're coming from Docker and you're using Podman, a lot of the commands, such as pulling, pushing, and building, are the same. So let's go down here and actually check this out with some of the Podman commands that we would use on a day-to-day basis. So say we want to pull a container down from a registry. So say we have the Nginx container right here. We would do podman pull, and then give the name of the image that we want to pull down. So for this one, we can do Nginx. Now we're pulling from our default Docker Hub or key.io registry. And we're pulling down this image. Now that we've got this image in our local registry, now we can run it with podman run. And of course, we can add any flags here that we'd like to expose ports, to mount volumes, whatever it might be. So we'll also call the Nginx image right there. Now that we have a running container on our system, to list it and any other active containers, we can do podman ps. And this will list any active containers. Now, this is just a small subset of the podman commands that we'll use on a day-to-day basis. And you'll notice it's very similar to Docker if you have Docker experience. But podman doesn't just stop at the commands. Podman goes a step further with something known as podman pods. So much like Kubernetes pods, a pod is a group of one or more containers that share the same volume and the same network. So think of it as a single host network where both of the containers can talk to each other with seamless networking. Now, let's say we have our Java application here that we've been working on. This could be a backend for our application, and we can use this Nginx image that we pulled down earlier as an Nginx container working as a reverse proxy to route the traffic. Now, with Podman, we can run this pod, and additionally, we can export the manifest to our cluster. So if we're learning Kubernetes and we're using, say, Minikube, we can export this directly to our cluster. So Podman can be super helpful with learning Kubernetes. So to recap everything, in this fast-changing world of containerization and microservices, Podman is a robust container engine that helps with security, with efficiency, and with seamless deployment of your containerized applications. So thanks so much for watching. My name is Cedric Clyburn. Stay tuned to the channel for more whiteboard videos, and have a great day. Thanks for watching this video. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.